Carolyn. She just found the perfect apartment.
Vicky's here with Billy and Cade.
Certainly. She'd like to speak with you.
Thank you. Carolyn!
Hi.
I'm gonna miss you so much. And I guess I won't get to see you to say goodbye. I love you too. And would you promise that you'll stay in touch?
Oh, I will.
Okay. Bye-bye. I am really gonna miss her. Look, we'll just see ourselves out.
Hold on, darling. I'm gonna see them to the door. Thank you so much for coming. And again, Billy, I'm sorry for frightening you.
I'm sorry, too.
Oh, and before I forget, I have a list of a few piano teachers that I can recommend without hesitation.
Oh, thank you very much. I appreciate this. I'll call them tomorrow. Oh, and Michael, please stop over and say goodbye before you leave.
Absolutely.
Now just promise me that the next time you'll come to me first, before taking the law into your own hands. Okay?
Okay.
Do you feel better?
I feel kind of dumb.
Oh, it's over and done with. Forget it. Michael has already forgotten about it, I'm sure. I want you to do me a favor. Remember the guy I told you about? The one I think is pretty neat? Well, we're going out tomorrow night. No pranks. Okay? Best behavior?
Okay. Can I have my friends over and watch a video?
I'll think about it. Now come on up to bed. That's enough, Cade. It's time for bed. Michael give you that piece? That's from his opera, isn't it?
I think so.
Well, what's it called?
Markella Jam something.
That's pretty. Okay, come on, both of you. Up to bed.
Chambers is lying. He killed the lady.
What'd you say?
Mr. Chambers is lying. He killed the lady.
You heard what he said. That was a student, and they were practicing a scene from his opera.
They weren't pretending, because she never got back up after he pushed her down.
She never got up? Wait a minute. How do you know that?
I saw them fighting and yelling.
When?
When you went to the bathroom.
You saw what I saw? Why didn't you tell me this sooner?
Every time I try to tell you, you always tell me to shut up.
I knew he was lying. I could feel it. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. He's gonna try and get rid of that body tonight. I just know it. We're gonna have to take turns watching his house. Okay, it's 11 o'clock. We got 7 hours till it's light. You tired?
No.
Okay, then you take the first 3 hours and I'll take the last four.
Okay. Think we should tell Mom?
No, Mom thinks Chambers is an angel.
If you see or hear anything funny, just wake me up.
Okay. I gotta look into that freezer.
What time is it?
2 o'clock.
Did you see or hear anything funny?
No, but the music is still turned up real loud.
The music is still on?
Yes.
He's up to something. We gotta see what he's doing. Come on.
They just brought it out of the house.
What?
The freezer.
The freezer? Give me the binoculars. We've got to talk to Mom.
Freezer, you gotta believe me. If they put that freezer on the truck, nobody will ever know.
As soon as I'm finished eating, I'm calling your grandmother. I'm sending both of you away for at least 2 weeks. You guys are driving me crazy with this.
But, Mom, you got 2 witnesses now. Cade and me. That lady wasn't Mrs. Chambers, and they weren't practicing any scene from any stupid opera.
It's true, Mom. It really is.
Michael.
Good morning, Vicky. Boys, Carolyn called just a few minutes ago. She doesn't feel we have room in the new apartment for our freezer. Rather than going through the hassle of moving it and storing it, we thought maybe you would like to have it. Actually, Vicky, you'd be doing us a favor.
We'd love it. Thank you.
You're most welcome. I'll have the movers bring it over this morning. I've already cleaned it out.
So what are your plans?
Well, the movers will finish up with the piano sometime tomorrow morning. And I'll be catching a plane sometime around noon tomorrow. So, if I don't see you again, thank you for being such wonderful neighbors and friends.
Oh, I am sure gonna miss hearing you play that piano every night.
You're very kind. Well, goodbye, Billy. Goodbye, Cade. You keep practicing and you'll be famous, I promise. Goodbye.
Bye, Michael. Shame on you both. So help me, if I hear one more word about a murder, I'm going to murder you. Now go and find something to do, or I'm going to put you to work cleaning out that garage. Move!
Thanks.
Here you are.
I'm looking for Michael Chambers. Michael Chambers.
Come on. What are you doing? Let go.
Shut up and come with me.
Just let go.
She was last seen at the corner of Center and 7th.
That makes sense. That's the bus stop right below our house. Are you sure this is the woman that asked you where Chambers lived?
Yeah.
I wonder where he put the body.
He killed his wife.
Okay, I was wrong. When Cade let Boo out 2 nights ago, this woman talked to Cade and asked him where Chambers lived.
So how do you know she went to Chambers' house?
Read the name on that.
Where'd you get this?
Cade got it from Chambers the morning after he killed her. She must have taken it to his house that night.
So do you still think the body's in the freezer?
Oh, not anymore. Last night he buried it under his house.
You mean he dug up the cement and buried her?
No. Their house is like ours. In the front there's a crawl space, and in the back there's a small basement. Last night he pushed the piano out of the way.
Give me this. I'll explain it.